Welcome. Today I will explain what is potential transformer. I also will explain about its application, specification and test. Potential transformer is also called PT. Potential transformer is a step down transformer which provides voltage in the secondary in correct magnitude and phase. Correct magnitude means magnitude of secondary will be proportional to the primary. And correct phase means, here I have shown, suppose this is primary voltage here and this is secondary voltage here. So I have shown two, one is green, one is red. Green is correct because there is no delay, there is no phase shift between this voltage and this voltage. You see, starting point is same. But red color is not okay. Here phase shift is there. Now voltage ratio of secondary and primary, V2 by V1 is equal to turn ratio, N2 by N1. Here I have shown one typical PT, electromagnetic type, which is connected to high voltage. This is high voltage line, maybe 10 kV, 50 kV, 100 kV or 220 kV. This is primary, second terminal is always grounded, this is core and this is secondary and load is connected. Now this is basic magnetic core circuit of PT. This is core. This is primary winding shown in red color. This is secondary winding shown again in red color. When we apply voltage across primary winding, a flux will flow. That flux is shown here by green color. This is flux. This is equivalent circuit of PT. Here I have not shown two separate winding. I have clubbed. This is shown core loss. This is magnetizing current. This is primary impedance. This is secondary impedance. This is the impedance of primary winding. Or this impedance of secondary winding. Because of these two, when we connect a load here, a current flows, so there will be drop. And if load is resistive or inductive, voltage will be less. To compensate that, what potential transformer manufacturer will do, they will provide additional few turns. Suppose by calculation 100 turns are coming, they will make 101, 102 or 103 to compensate this drop. That way they bring the accuracy in this PT. This is capacitor type PT, potential transformer. This is also called capacitor voltage transformer. It has no high voltage winding. There are two capacitors for voltage divider. This is used because cost of this divider is lower compared to winding type transformer. This point is grounded. Value of C1 will be more than C2. So when value of C1 is more, impedance of this C1 will be less, so less voltage will come here. This I have shown one isolating PT, but this is low voltage type. There is no high voltage PT. This is secondary, load is connected. This red color I have shown, dotted line, is shield for noise. This is also called Faraday shield. This is core. In primary I have shown 2-3 wires. Suppose this primary has 100 turns. So at 99 turn, 98 turn, 97 turn, they will take out some connection. to correct the ratio. If there is any error, they will change. This is called the tapping. This wire will be connected here. This is inductor to compensate the phase shift between this and this. In very high voltage, because of low cost, capacitor type PTR used. This has one more application in PLC, that is called the power line carrier, that used for communication. Now we come to applications. First application is measuring voltage, metering, that is called metering. We want to know what is the voltage at high voltage point. So we connect a PT, and secondary we connect to a voltmeter. This I have shown single phase. But generally power supply will not be single phase, it will be three phase in industries. So for three phase, we connect three PT, what I have shown here, black color, red color, green color. And three voltmeter will be connected. Or there will be one voltmeter with a switch. Then protections. Here there may be over voltage, there may be under voltage. If supply is three phase, there may be unbalance. Unbalance means voltage at all three phases will not be equal. So we use over voltage, under voltage and unbalanced relays for protection purpose. So PT is required for all these relays. Now synchronization. When you use thyristor, we have to give synchronized gate pulse with respect to incomer voltage or wherever thyristor is connected. So for that PT is used. Then controls. We are controlling some parameter. We may have closed loop control. For that purpose also PT are used. Generally, PT output in industry will not have 5 or 10 volt. It will have 110 volt. And IC cannot take 110 volt. It can take only 5 volt or 10 volt. So we use another PT to step down this voltage. This output goes here at the input of IC. Here I have connected one varistor to suppress the voltage surges coming here. And by using variable resistor here, we control the gain. So we make sure that we get some fixed voltage, say 5 volt RMS here, when 220 kV or 100 kV volt comes here. This is called voltage ratio calibration for control application. Then isolation. Some places we use PT only for isolation. Like earlier example, in capacitor voltage transformer, we were getting lower voltage but without insulation. So there we have used one isolating transformer. That is the application in isolation. Now we come to typical specifications. These are typical only. Actually, it will run in many pages. First, we have to give system voltage, incomer. What is the voltage and what is the variations? The more variation, transformer will be expensive because we have to design for more variations. Then ratio, we have to give. Here I have written 11 kV. For example, primary voltage is 11 kV. And secondary, there may be two winding. One may be 10 volt, another may be 15 volt. Or if you want third winding, you can write third winding voltage also. PT can have many secondary windings. This is primary voltage. Here means this is primary we have to tell, and these are secondary we have to tell. Then voltage factor. Incomer, generally there will be over voltage. It may be continuous, it may be for short time. So I have written here, you should be able to take 1.2 times of this voltage continuously. PT should work, it should not fail. And then this is short time rating. Means at this point, voltage can go up to 1.5 times for 30 seconds. PT should be able to take and it should not fail. Now this is VA rating, well done. I have written one single figure. This is total VA of all the winding. But we have to tell the VA of all winding. For example, this can have 3 VA, this can have 7 VA, so total will be 10. Then we have to tell accuracy class. What is the accuracy we want? I have written 0.5 class. This is a standard for this. Then we have to tell accuracy range. This accuracy we want for what range? Here I have written 80% to 120%. Means 80% of this voltage and up to 120% of this voltage, for this range we want this accuracy. In this case, 5 to 120% means from 5% of this voltage up to 120% of this voltage, this full range we want this accuracy. Generally, control application will require more range. Then frequency we have to tell. What is the frequency and variation? Then ambient temperature we have to tell. What is normal ambient temperature we want? It can be 70, it can be 50. Generally industry grade is 70 degree. Then standard, which standard we follow or what we want. It may be IS, it may be IES. Or it may be some other standard. Suppose we don't write anything, then manufacturer will follow the standard. Then we have to tell this PT we want to install where, indoor or outdoor. I have written indoor. Then terminal type. What type connection we want? It is nut bolt type, it is soldering type. Or we want loose wire. Now test. We have to tell what are the tests we have to do. Then any special requirement. Generally if you don't tell something, you will follow standard. But many times we have a special requirement. We want better quality or lower quality to reduce the cost. Then we can tell here. Now we come to test. Tests are two type, routine and type. Suppose we want 10 transformers. Then routine test will be done on all 10 transformers. But type test will be done only on 1 or 2 transformers. Then this is accuracy test. We see whether output voltage is coming accurately or not. But before doing this test, we check that multimeter is accurate or not, and multimeter is calibrated or not. Then dielectric insulation test. We apply high voltage across primary and secondary, or primary and ground, and see whether insulation is taking high voltage or not. Then temperature rise test. Suppose our transformer is 10 VA and 70 degree is the ambient temperature. Then we will connect full load 10 VA and keep that transformer in a chamber which has 70 degree temperature and keep that transformer on for many hours and see what is the temperature rise of the transformer. then terminal marking and polarity. We check type of terminal is given properly or not, like nut bolt, soldering or wire. Then marking P1, P2, S1, S2 is written or not. Then polarity is marked properly or not. Then special test all done, if any. Here I have shown one AC voltage. See, here voltage is low. Then suddenly voltage goes up. Then voltage comes down again. In control application, we want fast response. So we check when voltage goes high from low, then output also is going properly or not, or there is a delay. That is called the response time. So that is a special test, or it can be any other test. Today, this much only.